we talked last week about what it means to paraphrase. I watched you that, I showed you that silly commercial with the dog.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And what he was doing, and then he ran downstairs, and we talked about how we paraphrase all of the time. We paraphrase when we tell someone about something that we saw, something that we did, something that we watched. So now the trick is, how can we take that skill and transfer it and use it with academic reading? Because it's difficult. You are reading articles that are written by professional authors. You're reading things that are written by people that have a lot of education in their field, in textbooks. These are people with a lot of education and a lot of practice writing. How can you paraphrase what they've written? You can. It just takes a lot of practice. So we talked about some words. We talked about, do you remember what these little
quotation
marks are called?
Quotation marks.
Quotation marks, yes. And what does a quotation mark show us?
Let's see.
What does that show us if we see quotation marks around?
Somebody said that.
Someone said it, or someone else wrote it. It's someone else's ideas, right? So we also use the word brackets.
Marks used to hold information.
Exactly. Marks that we use to hold information. And for the way that we will use brackets, we place the author's last name. Not always the speaker, but the author. So if you are looking at your unique article or your common article for the group discussion, you are going to name the author. That way, when I am grading that component of the group discussion, I can look very quickly, and that tells me which article you took that text from. It helps me to be able to grade your work more accurately and more efficiently. So we talked about some things with paraphrase, and paraphrase means to
rewrite the sentence in your own way.
To rewrite someone else's sentence or ideas in your own way. Beautiful. So before I ask you to do this, like on the golden handout that I gave you for the project, I want to give you an opportunity to practice. So last week, you had four sentences that I showed you, and we paraphrased one of them together. Now, instead of asking you to do this by yourself, I think it would be valuable to have you work in groups.
Yeah.
And so each group is going to receive one of these papers, just one per group. And then working in your group, these are sentences that I took from the article that you read last week, the article called, Are You Getting Enough Sleep? And this page is really just for your practice. It's for guided practice. You read that article 2, 3, maybe 4 times. One of the groups is working on the topic of sleep. Some of you are reading about dreams. So you have background knowledge about this. So working with your group, I'm going to move you into groups in just a moment. You are going to take turns. You're going to talk about the sentence. You're going to write a group paraphrase, only one. And then we're going to come to the board, and I'm going to have you write your paraphrases underneath each one of the original sentences here. Here, here, and here. And then as a class, we will discuss and we will rank, or we will rate, which paraphrase we think is the best with no names, okay? So why don't we count off by numbers? We're going to mix up groups. I don't want you working with your discussion groups. It's good to mix it up, to mix ourselves up into many different groups. We'll count off and just remember your number, and then the ones will come together, the twos, the threes, you get the idea. So the same number one today, okay? Number two, come on, number three, actually. Number four, I think we have enough to do that. Number one, two, three, four, one, two, and three. So ones, raise your hand if you're a one. There should be four of you. Raise your hands, number ones.
Me, number one? No, number three.
One.
You're number three, yeah.
One. One, okay. This is your paper. So all you need is a pencil, you don't need anything else. I'm going to ask the ones to stand up and move to another part of the room. Okay? You don't need anything else, just a pencil. other ones. Number twos. Twos. There should be three of you. Okay. Maria, who else is a two? Twos. Twos. Come together. You can go to a different place in the room. You only need a pencil, nothing else. Threes. York. And fours. Come together. Sit any place that is comfortable. Make some space between you and the other groups.
How many?
Miss, all the group, just pick one sentence or?
Number four.
How many?
You're going to paraphrase each of the sentences that work with your group to do it.
Decide.
Will one of you do all of the writing, or do you want to pass the paper around and each person writes one? One person will have to write two.
So my God,
remember, sometimes we can change the order of ideas too. We don't have to keep them in the same order. We can flip clauses. Well, let's read.
I have the idea that I don't know how to
say
all the words together.
What is the relationship? I see cause and effect. What is the cause there?
The cause is more for
that's the cause, or is that the effect? What is the cause? What does that mean, modern expectations? Do you remember from the article? When do you watch television? When do you watch your shows on television and movies? Do you have to wait until they come on TV? Or on demand, right?
play. If you have Xfinity, you can watch on whenever you want. So when it is convenient for you. My husband and I were watching television last night. We recorded something. And I said, do you remember when we were little and we had to wait until 9 o'clock on Sunday and that was the only time you could watch that program? So that's the old time. Now in modern times, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, like the article said, 24/7. So if you think about, this is the cause, this is the effect, that might help you to form your paraphrase. Maybe you could even start with the cause and then share.
Do we have to change the
Do you think you could change modern expectations to something different? What does modern expectations mean? Maybe using the word access? Access to what? Well, modern is right now. So in recent times. So maybe access to... What do we have access to anytime? We have access to television or to movies, but it's more than that. For the internet, we have access to... And what else? On YouTube. What can you watch on YouTube? News, information, entertainment.
So access to...
Sure. Is there like a general word, like a category you can use? Social media? Okay, sure. I think that sounds good. Catching up on Netflix series. You might think about the vocabulary word adequate. That might help you with the first paraphrase. Adequate. We don't want to be an adequate student. We want to be better than adequate. Many of you said that on the test, but we must get adequate sleep, adequate nutrition, adequate access to clean water.
So this is the lack of sleep.